The Green Schools Initiative is in the second phase with support from Food and Agricultural Organization, FAO, sponsored by Swedish Embassy, Uganda. Vision Group undertakes training of coordinating teachers in the various regions, with already 100 schools selected, 10 from West Nile region. Uganda has more than 1.6 million refugees, with West Nile region accommodating 778,636, according to records from Office of the Prime Minister. Lois Bako, the deputy head teacher in Mvepi Secondary School in Mvepi Refugee Settlement, explains making of briquettes and innovations to reduce tree cutting, greening the school environment and tree planting.
We encouraged the learners in trying to solve environmental problems like reducing the usage of firewood. They were able to come up with some innovations on making of briquettes, how they can use this in their kitchen, how the school can use it. Added a little bit of tree planting and also the issue of recycling waste, most especially the polythenes, the plastics. We are able to manage them.
Basically, we run projects like we do trainings like in carpentry, and you know, with the carpentry there are byproducts like sawdust. So out of the sawdust, what we do is we make sure we mix it up to make briquettes, which we can still use as a cooking gear instead of cutting firewood, which really helps us so much. We are embarking on tree planting, and since where we come from, the place is so hot, which is not a little bit conducive for tree growing, but what we do is we do irrigation.
Well, the learners used not to have idea about Green School Initiative. They used to just dispose the rubbish anyhow. They used to carry polythene bags at school, but this time around the polythene bags, we have eliminated them completely.
Stanley Ogarewo, the patron of Green Schools Initiative at Mooney Girls Secondary, recounts the agroforestry and nursery bed established after Mooney Girls participated in the first phase Green School Initiative.
This agroforestry which we have established at the school, we're able to plant many seeds and we're able to raise a lot of seedlings. These seedlings, we planted some of them at our school and were able to supply some of the seedlings to the community around and the institutions like the primary schools and the church, which we have in the school, were able to supply all these. And some of the excess seedlings, we were able to give them to the students to go and plant at their home.
Sydney Miria, the project coordinator for Green School Initiative at Vision Group, who trained the teachers in West Nile, made emphasis on the need to change the attitude of community on climatic change that has caused displacement, flooding and long drought.
We are here to go and try and change behavior in communities. In a, first with our schools. Our schools are going to be our Jerusalem. Then the communities from which the children are will be the Samaria and the ends of the world. So each one of us can do something about climate change.
In West Nile region, the schools that have been selected are Mooney Girls SS, Bishop Angelo Tarantino SS, Bondo Army Secondary School, St. Joseph's College, Ombati, Diofe Girls SS, Arua Public Secondary School, Oleba Seed Secondary School, Erusi Secondary, St. Martin Komboni, and Mvepi Secondary School. Report compiled by Robert Ariaka for the news.